Unit 4, Collecting Information, Nonfiction, is an entire unit devoted to the wonderful world of nonfiction. We aren't talking about dry textbook nonfiction. We are talking about the genre of nonfiction. This unit introduces your students to nonfiction books that require them to understand author credibility, reliability, and bias. From beginning to end, this unit lays the foundation for the critical nonfiction reading skills students will need in college and beyond. This unit has a total of 9 lessons. Early lessons address the new text features and structures that students will be encountering with nonfiction books. Then, as the unit progresses, students analyze their text through close examining the author, the citations, and the content. To prepare for teaching the unit, read over the entire unit overview. This has all of the information you need to understand the purpose of the unit, how long it will take to teach, what you need to do to prepare, and the standards that you'll be covering. The free sample lesson, in the links below or in the Additional Resources tab on the product page of our website, is Lesson 5, Deciphering the Code, Finding the Central Idea and Using Support. You'll see up at the top is your list of materials. This lesson requires a pre-selected nonfiction passage and 3 handouts. This passage is not in bold, so that means it is not included in the resource. The handouts, on the other hand, are all in bold text, which means that they are found immediately following the lesson. Their page numbers are listed here too, to help you find them. In the parentheses after the name of the handout, you'll see how many copies of the handout you'll need for each student. For each of these handouts and the passage, you only need 1 copy per student. Following the materials list is a note about preparation. When you see this section at the top of any lesson, it lets you know that there is more to do to prepare for the lesson than just make copies of handouts. In this note, you are given more guidance on what kind of nonfiction passage you'll need and some ideas on where to find it. Finally, right before we dive into the lesson are the Common Core Anchor Standards. You'll notice that just the codes are listed here. If you want to know what the specific language of the standard is, just flip back to the standards alignment chart provided in the unit overview. Now we can get into the lesson. If you remember from the How to Use training video, the Connection section provides a greater context for why you are teaching this lesson. It was written just for you, but feel free to paraphrase it for your students. After reading the Connection for this lesson, you'll learn that the focus of this lesson is on differentiating the central idea from supporting detail. As you look over the instruction/modeling section, you may notice that it is written in a mix of plain text and italicized text. Remember from the How to Use training video, the plain text indicates the directions just for you, while the italicized text is teacher speak, which models what you should say to your students. In this lesson, students will learn about central idea and how to find it. In the practice section, students will practice finding the central idea using the nonfiction passage that you selected prior to the lesson. This activity also helps students learn the important skill of annotation. Then students will take what they have learned and apply it to their reading using the What's the Big Idea handout, which they will trade with a partner during the share section. On the following pages, you'll find the included note sheets and handouts for this lesson, all of which are specifically referred to in the lesson. Both Central Idea Defined and Best Supporting Detail are examples of a note sheet. The student version is the first and the teacher copy is second. The teacher copy is a guide for you to use during the instruction section of this lesson. Last is the What's the Big Idea activity handout used in the reading task section. Additional information about Reading Workshop Unit 4 can be found in the links below, or you can reach out to us here. If you did not watch the How to Use Reading Workshop for the Secondary Classroom, be sure to check that out for more information on all included Reading Workshop resources, as well as more information on the structure and format of the units and lessons. In the next video, we will cover Reading Workshop Unit 5, Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.